from San Francisco, California. This is the Rock and Roll Geek Show.
This is the story of my rock and roll butler.
Welcome to the Rock and Roll Geek Show. My name's Michael Butler. Thanks a lot for joining me. I really appreciate it. Today is Friday, December 21st, 2018, and this is day 20 of the Dog Days of Advent, where I'm trying to do a show a day all the way through Christmas. It is 3:30 p.m. when I'm recording this episode. I just got home from work. After I actually finished work around 1 o'clock, went to the bait store, got some bait because I'm planning on going fishing tomorrow. I am going to a Northern California Kayakers Association holiday dinner tonight in San Jose. That should be fun. I went last year. It's a White Elephant gift exchange. I'm still new to this whole group, but everybody's really nice. And last year I had a lot of fun, so I'm going to go again this year. Today, oh, by the way, tomorrow I will probably record a little bit on the way, because I'm heading down, I'm getting up after this party tonight, I'm driving home, setting my alarm for probably 3:30 a.m., I'm going to leave my house at 4 o'clock and drive up to Timber Cove and go fishing again with that guy Sean and some other people, and on the way up, I'll probably record a little bit, and then I'll record a little bit more on the way back. I'll tell you how my fishing went. Maybe I'll record on the water, but I'm not comfortable enough yet to be so distracted where I can record stuff while I'm fishing, because I'm still kind of new to this, and I don't want to die in the waters, if you get my drift. And plus, this is only the second time ever taking this new Hobie Outback out, so still have to get used to this thing. But maybe I'll get the wild hair and record a little bit while I'm on the water. We shall see, friends. But today I would like to say happy birthday to the great Frank Zappa. He was born on December 21st, 1940. That would make him he would have been 78 years old. Is that right? Something like that. I think 78. Yes, 78 years old. I cannot picture a 78-year-old Frank Zappa. First time I ever heard about Frank Zappa, my stepdad, John, turned me on to Frank Zappa when I was about 10 years old, maybe 9 or 10 years old. He had an album called Zoot Allures that had, I think that had Disco Boy on it, and maybe, I don't think Bobby Brown was on that one. That might have been on, was that on Shake Your Booty? I don't know. I'm not an authority on his whole catalog. But when I first started doing a podcast, about 6 months after I started doing the show, this guy, Jeff Rugby, who I've had on the Rock and Roll Geek Show before, he used to work for Ryko Disc, and he sent me almost the entire, because Ryko Disc reissued almost all of the Frank Zappa catalog, and Jeff Rugby sent me on CD all the Frank Zappa stuff, and I was extremely grateful for that, because he's got a ton of shit out there that is just too much to peruse. If you don't know much about Frank Zappa other than the name and you know, the mustache and the soul patch and all that, it can be kind of overwhelming. The one I would suggest everybody probably go, if you're new to Frank Zappa, the first one I would suggest is actually the first one I ever bought, is an album called Joe's Garage, Acts 1, 2, and 3. It is a three-album set. I got it it came out in 1979, and I think that's when I got it. I was in 12th grade. Pardon me, let me take a sip of this fine Tecate. That album was actually a hit. The song Joe's Garage was probably a top 40 hit. What's interesting about that album, he did this thing that he called, I'm looking on the Wikipedia, what did he call this type of recording, where he took guitar solos from live performances and put them over studio performances. He calls it Zeno something or other. Looking on the Wikipedia here. Anyway, the album it's a great album. It's called kind of a rock opera. It's a concept album. It tells the story of it's kind of a cautionary tale told through the eyes of, or told through the narration of Frank Zappa playing the part of the central scrutinizer. He talks about the government takes over, is taking over music, and kids should not get into music, and he tells a cautionary tale about a guy named Joe who started a garage band and falls in love with a girl named Mary who is played by Dale Bozzio from Missing Persons. Terry Bozzio plays drums on the album. Warren Cucurillo from Missing Persons, the guitar player, plays rhythm guitar on the album. Frank Zappa plays lead guitar and does the singing. Had a guy named Denny Wally play slide guitar. Star, a great band. I mean, virtual. He's always had virtuoso bands, as you well know. So Del Bozzio plays the part of Mary. Warren Cucurillo and Ed Mann play some guy named Cyborg. Frank Zappa is the central scrutinizer. And the central scrutinizer tells a story about this guy, Joe, who fell into the evil ways of rock music and meets a girl who takes him down a bad path, and then he gets sexually transmitted disease. It's a fun story, and it's a really great album. I mean, it's pretty much a masterpiece. I don't think Frank Zappa thought too highly of this album. He called it like a stupid little story about how the government is going to do away with music. I'm still looking for this... what he calls this thing. Joe's Garage is noted for its use of Xenochrony. It's a studio-based musical technique developed at an unknown date, but possibly as early as the early 60s, by Frank Zappa, who used it on several albums. Xenochrony is executed by extracting a guitar solo or other musical part from its original concept and placing it into a completely different recording. The only two solos on this album that are not Xenochrony are Crew Slut and a song called Watermelon and Easter Hay. I'm gonna play Watermelon and Easter Hay for you. It is a 9-minute song, but it is my favorite... It's my favorite Frank Zappa guitar solo. And when I was looking on the Wikipedia, Frank Zappa said that he thinks Watermelon and Easter Hay is the best song on this album, Joe's Garage. And Dweezil Zappa says it is Frank Zappa's finest guitar solo work of all of his recorded stuff. If you want to hear a genius play guitar, man, if you're listening to this in your car or whatever, crank it up full blast or put on some headphones and listen to this... to the guitar solo in this song, because it is just sheer brilliance. There's also a couple of documentaries about Frank Zappa as well. There's one I watched about a year or so ago called Eat That Question. I thought it was made by his kids, put it together. I'm not sure about that, though, but it's a good documentary, and it's kind of sad. It's all archive footage, but you see him when he has cancer and he talks about he knows he's going to die, and it's really sad. But and there's a great, great concert film called Baby Snakes, which mixes animation and live concert performance. It's really, really good. I haven't seen that in probably 20 years, but I would suggest you look for that as well. All right, thank you for listening, friends. I hope you enjoyed this little tribute to Frank Zappa. Happy birthday, Frank Zappa, the genius known as Frank Zappa. If there is anybody that can be classified as a genius, it is Frank Zappa. So I'm going to play Watermelon and Easter Hay. Thank you for listening, friends. I will talk to you tomorrow for day 21 of the Dog Days of Advent. Take a sip of this fine Tecate to everyone. I hope everybody's off until Christmas. And if you have any time, I hope you listen to the Rock and Roll Geek Show. May take a sip of this fine Tecate for everyone. Ah... Find this show at rockandrollgeek.com. Find me on the Facebook, R&R Geek. Find me on the Twitter, R&R Geek. Find me on the Instagram, Rock and Roll Geek. Don't ask. Also, I need your top 10 albums of 2018. I'm going to start a new thread. A lot of people have already been posting them on the Facebook page, on the Rock and Roll Geek Facebook page, which I did not create, but I do approve people. You just have to answer two simple questions so I know you're not a Russian hacker. I'm going to create a new thread, so hopefully everybody can repost their top 10 albums of 2018, because when I do mine, probably in a week or so, I'd like to mix other people's in as well and compare notes with everybody. All right, I have not finished putting mine together. I've whittled it down to about 20. I always say, always thinking to myself, oh, this is not a great year for rock music. And then when I started to whittle my list down, I find out there's a lot of good albums. So I'm always wrong. So I need yours. I'm going to start a new thread. I'll probably do that tonight. Post yours on the new thread. If you've already posted yours, I'm sorry to ask you, but if you could repost them again on the new thread, I would much appreciate it, friends. And thank you for the donations. Please keep the donations coming, because without your donations, this show would die a horrible, putrid, stench-filled death. And my birthday is coming up on Monday. What better way to make me happy, friends, by sending me a donation? Huh? $1,000? $100? $200? $50? $25? $5? I don't care. Just send me, if you can. Not ordering you to send me a donation, but your donations are much appreciated, friends. All right, here is Watermelon in Easter Hay. Put on your headphones now, if you're into this, for 9 minutes and 5 seconds. Listen to sheer guitar brilliance. Thanks for listening. I'll talk to you tomorrow, friends.
This is the Central Scrutinizer. Joe has just worked himself into an imaginary frenzy during the fade-out of his imaginary song. He begins to feel depressed now. He knows the end is near. He has realized at last that imaginary guitar notes and imaginary vocals exist only in the imagination of the imaginer. And ultimately, who gives a fuck anyway? So, excuse me. So, who gives a fuck anyway? So he goes back to his ugly little room and quietly dreams his last imaginary guitar solo.
It's a rock and roll geek train wreck.